Hello, welcome back everyone. Hope you enjoyed the last class. I'm going to do something quite similar, it won't be too taxing, but I'm going to do a lot of abs. I met Nicola Gear and Babs this morning and they demanded some ab work, so a lot more abs. It'll be a little bit, the intensity will be a little bit higher today, so hope you brought your A game. So we're just going to start down on all fours. So hands directly underneath your shoulders and knees directly underneath your hips, okay? From there, I want you to just relax your spine, so a nice kind of neutral spine, which is, so just relax it basically. Don't be tucking your pelvis underneath you or sticking your bum too far away. So nice and relaxed, okay, from here. We're going to just open up the lungs a lot and get the breathing under control and get the body warmed up. From here, we're going to relax into an inhale. And on the exhale, I want you to tuck your pelvis in underneath you, okay? Drive your spine towards the ceiling, so you're lifting the middle part of your spine towards the ceiling. Drive into the mat with your hands and relax your head down. Look in between your legs. Relax your neck when you're in this position. Get rid of any tension. I want you to look right and to the left, okay? And back to center. In here to stay. And on the exhale, we're going to bring the bum away. So soften the back. Stick that the glutes away to the back of the room. And then come on back up, looking straight ahead. Nice strong arms. Inhale to stay. Exhale, tucking the hips again. So really rounding the lower back. Pushing into the hands, into the floor, and really driving the spine towards the ceiling, bringing the shoulder blades away from each other. Squeezing the glutes a little bit in this position and using your abs to stay here. Hold it. We're going to stay here for a few breaths, breathing in and exhaling. This is quite demanding on the lungs here because you're in a compression. Inhale to stay and then exhale. Again, relaxing the neck. Inhale to stay and exhale. Breathing in through the nose. And exhale through the mouth. Two more breaths in and out. Strong arms again, breathing in, relax the feet. And exhaling. On the next exhale, we're gonna relax the spine, breathing in. And slowly bringing the pelvis away, sticking the glutes to the back of the room, soften your back and coming looking up. Okay, from here, come into a nice shell. Stretch up, open the body, open the knees away from each other and bring the body towards the mat. Okay, bring it down as far as you can. Go down, no pressure. If you suffer with anything with the knee area, you want to prop something underneath your glutes and resting on the calf, that'll take the pressure off your knees, okay? So relax the body down onto the floor and just take a minute here. Bring the left arm to the left side of the room and reach with your right arm onto your left hand and relax down. Get a nice stretch along the lats and then reaching over to the right and then bring your left hand onto the right side and just hold. We're still warming the body up. From here, guys, we're just going to go into some leg extensions. We're not going to do the full Superman, so we're just going to work the legs and get the glutes fired up. So, strong arms again, no bend in the elbows, okay? Really draw the shoulder blades away from each other. So, push into the floor. From here, we're just going to extend the left leg away. Nice long line, squeeze the glutes, point the toes, then bring the knee in towards your body and exhale. Breathing in and exhale. Squeeze the glutes. Inhale, bring the knee underneath your body. And exhale, bringing the knee in underneath, and exhale, go for four more, under, and two more, good, nice long lines, we're really pushing those toes away from you, and activate the quads, rest that knee down underneath the hips, get your body into the correct position again, knees directly underneath the hips and hands under your shoulders. And there, extending that right leg, nice long line. Bring it in for eight. Six. So you can increase the tempo a little bit, just maintain form. Good. And don't go too high if you feel that you're feeding into your lower back. And last one. And bring it down. And we're going to go onto our backs now. So come onto your bums, getting up nice and tall. I want you to place the hands at the back of your thighs, lower thighs, and from there, feet hip distance apart, and make sure that your toes are engaged with the mat, okay? Nice and tall, open up the chest. From here, we're going to inhale, and then on the exhale, I want you to round your spine, so rounding the belly area, holding onto the back of the legs, and let yourself roll back, lean back, and lift your chin. Inhale to stay, and exhale, tuck the chin, and rolling forward, nice and tall. Breathing in. And exhale, round and roll. Inhale to stay. And exhale. We're going to get rid of the hands now in a moment. We're just warming up. Inhale. gone out running this morning, Nicola and Babs. Inhale and exhale and round and roll. Good. Inhale to stay and exhale to round forward. Remember to tuck the chin, okay? Inhale, last one. Exhale, tuck the chin and roll back, round the stomach. And then extend nice and long. Inhale to stay and exhale to come forward. From there, we're going to release the hands. Nice long line with your arms. Hands facing down. Again, open that space between your ribs and the pelvis, okay? From here, we're going to inhale to stay and exhale. Same position with the spine. Round and roll back. Engage the toes with the mat and extend back. Inhale to stay and exhale, tuck the chin, round the stomach and coming up nice and tall. Inhale. Again, imagine there's a ball in between your knees and you're squeezing that ball, trying not to let the knees splay. Inhale to stay and exhale, round and roll. Inhale, stay here and exhale to roll forward. We're going to go for two more, okay? Again, visualize that ball in between the knees. Activate the hips and adductors. Inhale to stay and exhale. From here, guys, we're going to slowly let ourselves roll back onto the mat, nice and controlled, reaching those arms out slowly, slowly, one vertebrae at a time, coming down, coming down, coming down, and then relax your hands onto the mat. Feet hip distance apart. Make sure there's nothing under your head and make sure that your head is on level ground, because we're going to be putting our body weight into that upper body area, the shoulder blade area, and we don't want to put pressure on the neck. So feet hip distance apart, really engaging the feet with the mat, toes down, heels really digging into the floor, okay? Again, keeping that space hip distance apart with the knees, and you want to visualize there's something in between your knees and you're kind of compressing that, okay? So from here, we're going to do hip rolls. Inhale to stay, exhale, we're still warming the body up. We've got two more exercises. Inhale, stay here, and then exhale, roll back down, okay? If you feel into it, I want you to place your hands on your hips here for the next few, and just make sure that your hips are coming up evenly and then back down evenly. We generally lean to one side, so coming up, we all have a dog on the side. Inhale to stay, and then exhale, rounding slightly, rolling through an imprint, so you're rolling your whole spine down to the mat, one vertebrae at a time, and releasing your pelvis at the end. So kind of arch your lower back a little bit, exaggerate it a small bit, get a nice stretch in your abs. Inhale to stay, exhale, rolling through imprint, and lifting those hips up, squeezing the glutes, keeping the knees closer together, so hip distance. Inhale to stay, and exhale to lower down. Good. Make sure you are hip distance apart, because some people think that they're wider than they actually are. So don't be too nasty to yourself. And lifting up. Good. We're going to go for two more after this, and then lower down. Really feeling a nice mobilization coming into the spine. Relax your hands down. Once you're aware of what's going on with your hips, inhale to stay, resting on the shoulder blades, exhale to come back down. One more. Good. And last one. Inhale, stay, and exhale to roll back down. Good. From there, guys, we're going to bring one leg up to tabletop position, so that's 90 degrees, and we'll keep the other one bent for now. We're going to do a leg circle, so I want you to visualize a pen sticking out of your knee, and we're going to circle that leg from the hip socket, okay? So we're going to inhale, half a circle, and then exhale, okay? Breathing in, and this is our last warm-up exercise, and then we're going to get stuck in, okay? Well done. So we'll just do six each way, three more. And one more, and then we're going to go the opposite direction. Now, keeping that other hip nice and strong and into the ground, I don't want you lifting that opposite hip, okay? So if you're doing the right leg, keep that left hip down on the mat, okay? You should be going the opposite direction now if you haven't changed. One more, and then just bring that knee into your chest and extend the opposite leg. Activating the quads, I want you to get a nice opening stretch into that hip flexor, the opposite leg, okay? And then face that other leg down and bring the other leg to tabletop position. Okay, so make sure it's a nice 90 degree angle. And we're going to go inwards, down, and all the way back around. Now it's up to you how big the circle goes. The bigger, the harder it is. The smaller, the easier. You've got more control, the smaller the circle. Okay, so breathing in for half and out. Try not to hold your breath because it won't do you any good. One more.
And we're going the opposite way, please. 6, 5, 4, 3. Definitely feeling tighter on my left side. And one more. And bring that knee in. And again, contracting that quad, we open up that hip flexor. And release down. From there, feet onto the mat, hands behind the head. This is for you, Nicola. I'm glad you're getting a lot of air time today. I won't mention your name again. All right. Inhale to stay. Exhale and coming up into our prep. Lower down. And exhale. And lower down. And exhale. Squeezing those abs. Go as deep as you can into that ab prep. Keep the elbows back. Okay. And lower down. Hold. We're going to stay for an inhale. And on the exhale, go deeper. You might shake, that's okay. Inhale to lower. Exhale, come up. Inhale to stay. Exhale, go deeper. Inhale, lower down. And up. One for five more. Four. Three, we're going to hold the next one. Inhale to stay. Exhale, go higher. Inhale, go down. And two. And one more. And lower down. From here, keep the elbows where they are and hands are there. We're going to bring one leg to tabletop. If you need to bring your hands out to support yourself, that's fine. And bring the other leg to meet it. Bring your hands back to where they were originally. We're going to inhale and on the exhale coming up. Slowly. Inhale to lower down. And exhale. Inhale to lower. Keeping that lower back in connection with the mat. So you don't want to lose that space with your lower back on the mat, okay? Once you start to feel that you're losing it, place your feet back down onto the floor. Continue with the ab prep, okay? Or if you have any pain in your lower back, bring your feet onto the mat. Good. Four to go. Three. Two. And one. Keep the legs there. Reach the hands towards the shins, outer shins. We're going to inhale, relax your head down onto the mat, reach your arms, and then exhale, coming up and touching your shins, okay? So you get your neck a bit nice and rest in between, okay? Because it is hard on your neck to stay in that position. And reach. Breathing in as you extend again, don't lose that connection with your lower back on the mat. Okay, or if your neck is sore, you can support your neck with one hand and then alternate, okay? Because we're going to be doing something similar on the next exercise. So support your neck if you are suffering with your neck, okay? We're not finishing anytime soon with the abs, so get used to your legs being in tabletop position for the next little while. And breathing through it. And two. And from here we're going to extend back with the arms. Nice big circles, okay? Really activate and relax as you come down with your arms and reach.
1 second, Kay.
Big circle.
Go through that again. 1 second, I'll tell you. I'm after losing connection here.
Okay, so we're going to inhale as you extend back.
One sec. I can go through. It's still recording, but okay. It's not live.
Okay. Now inhale to reach back and exhale to come. Inhale to extend back, bring the arm right around and reach. And we're going for five more. Four. Three. Keep that connection to the lower back. Last two. And don't lose your positioning of your legs, please. One more. And hold. From here, I want you to extend the legs straight. Release the arms. We're going for the 100. Inhaling for 4, 3, 2, 1, and out. 4, 2, 1, in. 4, 3, 2, 1, and out. And in. And out. And in. And out. Inhale. And halfway. And in. And out. Lower the legs if you want. In. And out, 30 to go, in, and out, and in, and out, and last big breath in, And exhale and hold. 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 Higher. Lower. Higher. Lower. Relax your head there. Good. Well done. I hope you made it through that bit. I was a bit cruel there, I'm sorry. Okay, from there guys, on to your front. We are going to do plank. So nice long line of the body. Okay, and extend our left leg back. And our right leg. I want you to really push the heels away, squeeze the glutes, hands directly under your shoulders. I want you to hold this position for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring the bum to ceiling, heels down, and then back into plank for 5. Bums to ceiling, and 4. And push up. My feet are slipping. I haven't got the right socks on. Keep going. And more. And back in. And hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Gently come down onto your left side. We're going to go into side plank from here. Okay? So I generally start with a bent knee position, elbow directly under your shoulder. We're going to inhale and then exhale, coming up onto your elbow. Make sure it's directly under your shoulder, and then release the upper hand, okay? We're going to breathe in and exhale. Breathe in and exhale. Make sure that your hips are level, that you're not rotating back, okay? If you feel that's happening, bring the upper foot in front, and that'll bring the hip forward, okay? So breathing in and out, and then reach in under the armpit, breathe in, release for 3, 2, and 1. Slowly come down, resting the body down. We're going to go into glute activation. Nice long line of the body. Okay, rest your head down, ankles, knees, hips, shoulders, all in one line. I want you to make kind of a space in under your waist here, okay? So keep the activation in your abs, don't lose that. We're going to go for this knee lift, or leg lift, sorry, for now. We're going to go for 20 of them. So warm up the glutes. Good. Breathing in as you lift, and exhale as you lower. Well done. Keeping that tension in the quads, squeezing the glutes. And only go as high as you feel that you feel comfortable, where you're not bending your knee. Please don't bend the knee. Avoid it if you can. 7, 6, 5. Remember to keep this nice and tight. 3, 2, and 1. From here, guys, I'm going to get you to lift your top leg, and then you're going to bring your bottom leg to meet it, and then you're going to bring them down together. Inhale to lift the top leg. Exhale, bring the bottom leg to meet, and then coming back down. Inhale. Exhale, and bring them back down. Inhale, exhale, and back down. Lifting up, 3 to go. And back down, 2. And back down, and 1. And back down, okay? From there, I want you to bend the top leg, okay? Now we're doing circles, but we're doing it with a bent knee position. So you're going to feed into the glutes a little bit more than you would with a straight leg, okay? So I want you to visualize the pen sticking out of your knee, alright? And you're drawing a circle away from you, alright, with that knee. So we're going to inhale forward, kick back with the foot, and back around. Now control the abs. I don't want you to arch your back. So tuck the pelvis a little bit and stay strong through the abs. So you're going to tuck your pelvis underneath you. Big circle, squeeze, inhale, and exhale, inhale, sorry my water bottle's in the way, keep going, in, and pushing back, really feeding into the glutes, again control the pelvis, stay strong, if you want to bend that lower leg a little bit you can, it would also take the pressure off your lower back if you needed to, It gives you a bit more control, okay? Good. And hold after this one. Hold it. Knee in line with your hip to begin. And then we're going forwards and back around, okay? Really nice burner for the glutes. You're not going to like me after this, sorry. And three, two, and last one. Now, I didn't say drop the leg, keep it up, nice line with the hip. And we're going to open the leg, and then I want you to bring your knee to the ceiling. And then bring it all the way back down. Inhale to lift, and then open that knee to ceiling. And then bring the leg back down. Inhale, and then exhale, really getting the adductors working, glutes fired up, and back down. Open up the hip socket, and open, and then back, all the way back down. We're going to do five more. Don't drop out, the burn only lasts temporarily, so keep going. Well done. And three. Two. Sometimes I lose track of counting Mick there, so if you ever need to correct me too. Last one. Toby would agree if he's watching again. And relax down. Nice smack on the back side. From there, we're going to go back into side plank position. So when you're ready, elbow directly underneath you. Inhale and then exhale to extend into a nice long line. Again, reaching the hand, okay? We're going to inhale and reach in under. Exhale, release. Inhale to reach, and exhale. Inhale to reach, and exhale. Two more, inhale, and exhale. Inhale, pushing that hip up, and exhale. And relax down, back onto your front, please, before we do the other side. From here, we're gonna do leg pull front, so tucking the knees under the hips, hands directly under your shoulders, neutral spine. From here, take an inhale, tuck the toes, and exhale to lift up. I want you to bring your left knee in, bring it back. In. Three more. Two. And one. Tuck the toes. And five. Four. Three. Two. And one. Tuck the toes. Hold. Hold. Should have brought my watch over. Ready? 10, 9. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, come down. Take a shell stretch before we do the other side, guys. I know I need it. So relax, go wide up the knees, and bring the bum down, the chest down onto the floor, okay? Take a moment. Big breath in, and then on the exhale, slowly coming up. From there, we're going to do the other side. Okay, so I'm going to start with side plank. Elbow directly under, take an inhale and exhale to come up and then release that hand. Holding, we're going to inhale as you reach. And two, we're going to do in three on the first one. And one, hold for five, four, three, two, and one, and come down gently. There, nice long line with the body. We'll start with our leg raises, okay? So we're going to inhale and then exhale. For 20, okay. Now just stay focused, breathing in and out. Really squeezing the glutes as you extend up. Keeping the leg nice and long, contract the quads, okay. Breathing in and out. Again, keeping those abs nice and strong. Okay, and make that little space underneath your waist. Good. And two more, and one, and coming down gently, okay? From there, we're going to inhale to lift the top leg. If you want to support your hand in front of you, you can. Exhale to lift the lower. Inhale, and lift. Inhale, drop them both. Exhale, lift. Inhale, lower. Good. And four more. Three, two, and from there. I'm going to bend the top leg. And as I said before, if you need to bend the lower leg, do so. Okay, we're bending that top leg and make sure that it's in line with your hip to begin, okay? So we're going to make circles. So bring the leg towards you, back. Imagine you're trying to kick someone with the sole of your foot. You really want to squeeze the glute. So go into a nice extension with the leg and back around. Okay, but controlling the abs. I don't want you to feed into the lower back too much, okay? Good. Nice circles with the knee. Halfway. Three, two, and one more. And then I'm going to get you to hold, and we're going to go forwards for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and hold your leg in line with your hip. Don't drop it. Open up that knee to ceiling, and then lower the leg for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, not cold now, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and relax that leg down. Give yourself a little smack, okay? Onto your side again, side plank. We're going to go for 5 this time, same as the other side. So when you're ready, 3, 2, 1, into side plank, okay? Bringing the hips forward. Nice long line. We're going to inhale as you reach under. Exhale. Inhale. As you reach, push that hip to ceiling. Good. Inhale. 2 more. 1 more. And slowly come back down, okay? Last front plank, please. Go long line this time, not leg to the front, so extending left leg and the leg to meet. Nice long line with your body, okay? We're gonna hold this position. And I want you to shift the weight forward onto your tippy toes and then push back. Inhale. Inhale. Last one. If you're supporting your wrist, just hold. 5, 4, 3, 2, gently come down. And you up onto your knees. Take a moment. We're going to go onto our backs again. Okay, so sitting onto your backside, nice and long. We're going to do roll-ups, okay? So what I want you to do is bring your tippy toes towards you, all right? Activate the front parts of your legs, the shins, and your quads, okay? So draw the kneecaps up. Really focus on bringing those toes towards you, it'll help, I promise. Okay, I want you to sit nice and tall. We're going to inhale, bring the hands out in front. And then exhale, scoop the abdominals. Exhale. So scoop the abdominals, roll back. Tuck in the chin, slowly. Coming down off the mat, one vertebrae at a time. So you're peeling your spine down off the mat. And then releasing all the way back. Inhale as we reach the back of the room, okay? Don't forget about the feet. Contracting the feet towards us, so bringing the tippy toes towards it. Squeeze the glutes, draw the belly in. Inhale, big breath, okay? Breathe in. And then exhale, hands reaching towards your toes, relaxing down. Inhale. Exhale, round the stomach. Tuck the chin. Slowly, 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 toes towards you. Don't lose that. Track the thighs, draw yourself down onto the mat. One vertebrae at a time, release the arms. Breathing in, exhale. And reach, inhale, exhale. Really round your stomach, tuck the chin. Looking at your belly. Slowly, 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 toes toward you. Coming down, coming down. Control, it's all about control, guys. And exhale. Good. We're going for 2 more. And round the lower leg. If you need to bend your knees, that's okay. Okay, don't feel bad. It's okay. You will get stronger. It's not an easy one to do, it looks easy. And exhale.
roll yourself back down.
Onto the mat. Okay. Now, bring yourselves into imprint position. So lock the mat and lower back down onto the mat, okay? We're going to bring one leg to tabletop. And we're going to bring the other leg to meet it, okay? And we're going for toe taps, hands down by your side. Make sure that you feel comfortable before you start this exercise. We're going to inhale as you reach down, touch your tippy toes off the mat, and then exhale to bring it up. In, exhale. We're going to do 20 of these. Mixed counting. 4, 5, 6. You're going to reach further. That's a little bit harder. So you're starting to challenge your lower back and your abs more. You want to try and keep that lower back onto the mat, and the further you go away, your back's going to want to extend, okay? I think we're halfway.
That's 12.
Okay. He's never off duty.
5 more.
Come on, you left. 3. 2. And 1. Okay, keep the legs where they are, please. We're going to take an inhale. And on the exhale, we're going to come up and touch the outer parts of our shins, okay? From here, you're going to extend your right leg. I want you to place your right hand on the inner part of your left leg and left hand on the outer shin, okay? We're going for a single leg stretch. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. In. Speed up. In. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold and lower down. Bring your knees into your chest. Just roll on your spine side to side. And we're going to do some hip flexor activation, okay? So from there, I'm going to get you to rest your body down, okay? Feet flat on the floor. We're going to extend that right leg nice and long. I want your knees to be parallel, hands resting down by your side. Toes towards you begin. You're going to lower that leg, keeping the pelvis nice and neutral. So lower, point your toes away as you bring it back up. Lift. Inhale to lower, exhale to lift. Inhale to lower, and exhale to lift. Again, bring the toes towards you on the way down, and away on the way. Toes away on the way back up. Okay? Last 2, and 1. Holding here, we're going to go for circles, okay? For 10, 9. Remember, no shifting of the pelvis. Use those abs, engage. Nice and strong. Good. It won't take you long if you do this at least 3 times a week. You're going to have it. You can save it on Facebook, not the other way. And try and get at least 3 of these sessions in, or 2 minimum. You won't feel it like a couple of weeks and you start to feel the difference. Your core will start to feel a lot stronger and controlled. And last one, bring that knee into your chest and release. Really pushing that other leg down to the floor. Okay, we're going to stretch this glute while we're here. So bring your knee to your opposite shoulder. Bring that leg across your body. I'm trying not to lift the hip too much. Keep some of your pelvis down to the floor. Now I should bring that leg across your body, across the other leg, up towards the other hip. Bring it down to the floor, so slowly. You want to wind your back. When you're ready, I want you to release that opposite hand to the back of the room, okay? And then look at that opposite hand, okay? You dictate how much pressure you put into that leg. So if you want to go deeper, just apply a little bit of pressure and go deeper into that stretch. You can bring your knee down to the floor, bridge. Sometimes you can get a little release in your lower back, it might click. That's okay. Just don't get stuck. And then bring your hand down to support yourself, place it onto your back, bend your knee, and slowly come out of that position, okay? From there, guys, knees back together, we're going to do the other side, okay? So just get comfortable with your pelvis, nice neutral pelvis, and extending that other leg. Toes towards you, hands down by your side. We're going to inhale to lower, exhale to lift for 10, 9, painting that wall, 8, 7, just mobilizing the ankle. 5, 4, 3, 2. two, and one. We're going to go for circles, knees parallel, outwards and in, for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, opposite way for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, bring that knee in through, and extend the opposite one, okay? Really pushing that leg again to the floor, bringing that knee in as close as you can. And then bring it across your body, knee to opposite shoulder, should feel it on your bum. Lovely stretch, holding. And then bringing that knee across your body, slowly winding your back, aiming to bring it down to the floor, okay? And then once you're feeling comfortable where you're at, support your knee down with your hand, and then release the other hand, okay? Opening up the chest, getting a nice bit of mobility into the spine, and opening the chest as well, okay? So it'll be stretch. Breathing into it. And then when you're ready, just bring your hand back onto your lower back, bring the knee towards you, and then slowly coming back down onto the mat. Okay, I'm going to do stretching. So coming up to seated position. I want you to bring the soles of the feet together. Okay, elbows in against the knees. And then just pushing out the knees away from each other, okay? Try and get a nice stretch on the adductor area. Okay? Sitting up nice and tall. Try not to let your abdominals kind of sink down. So open up that space. From there, we're going to open up, or bring the left leg outwards. Nice and long, and reach down towards your toes, keeping that foot in against your knee, and reach. Again, if you're only reaching towards your knee or your shin, that's far enough. Doesn't matter, once your leg is fully extended and locked out, gently locked out, that's good enough. You need to feel the stretch along the back of the leg, okay, the hamstring area. Sometimes it can feel a little bit nervy also, which is no harm. Okay. Breathing. Don't forget to breathe. This is great because I get to stretch too. I'm very good for stretching after I run. Okay. I shouldn't be saying that, but I am. Okay. Okay, so bringing the right leg out in front, and I want you to place your hands, both hands, on your inner leg, okay? On the inner part of the right leg. Really extending that back leg behind your hip area. So really bring that knee back behind the glute area into a nice long line. I want you to squeeze your bum. Okay, relax your foot, and I want you to, with your right elbow, kind of lean into that leg, the inner part of that leg, and feel a nice opening of the inner adductor area, okay? It's a nice area to get stretched because we don't stretch it enough, okay? So holding, and then from there, really relaxing, so keeping that weight into the right hand, I want you to release your left hand, stabilize, inhale, and then exhale, coming back down. Inhale, reaching. And then exhale, coming back down. Bring the other hand to the other side of the knee, and the other side of the foot, should I say, and I want you to come back into the extension of that leg and get a nice stretch along the hamstring, okay? Keeping the hands either side of the leg. And coming forward, and then extending back, toes towards you, get a deeper stretch if you bring the toes towards you. And then inhale, coming forward, nice stretch on the hip flexor, and then exhale, coming back. Slowly bend the knee, and we're going to swap over. Okay, hands on the inner part of the foot. Again, weight of this elbow in against the leg, so you want to push that knee away from you slightly, okay? Squeezing the glute in the back leg, and breathing into this. Breathe in, and exhaling. Breathe in, and exhaling. Engaging all your toes down onto the floor, breathing in, and exhaling. From there, weight of the full hand, the left hand, weight of it fully into the mat, so engage all your fingers down. Inhale as you reach. You don't feel stable enough to do this at the moment.
Okay, so now you're stretching the opposite side. Inhale. And exhale. Breathe in. And out. We're going for one more. Inhale. Again, don't force this one. If your knee is like slightly bent, that's okay. As I said before, once you're feeling that stretch, that's far enough, okay? Never force the stretch if it doesn't feel right, okay? You don't need to hurt yourselves, okay? From there onto your belly, nearly there, okay? Hands in line with your shoulders, okay? We're just going to stretch the abdominal area and open the back a little bit. Inhale and exhale. You can put a bit of weight into the hands, squeeze the glutes and push up. Inhale to lower. And exhale, squeeze the glutes, look out the legs. Inhale to lower. And exhale. Last one, inhale. And exhale. Coming up. Standing. Okay, so feet hip distance apart. Okay, hands down by your sides. I want you to inhale as you come up onto your tippy toes, reach the fingertips to ceiling. Out and wide, looking down. Inhale and reach. And exhale, coming down. Inhale to reach. And exhale, coming back down. Well done, everybody. Hello to